Hi, I'm Randall Barney. We're here at the NAB show speaking with teleport, satellite, and technology providers about their customer solutions, and here's what they had to say.
It means a big thing, actually. A total solution for me means connecting multiple silos of the network and multiple silos of compression and handling of media into one unified set of workflows. So we, as Skyline Communications, we provide the capability here on the show to set up end-to-end media workflows originating from the source, which can be a sports affiliate, which can be an SNG news feed, whatever, down to the distribution towards the consumer. So using unified workflows, you can see a little bit here, if you think about it. Typically, if you think on bringing media to the end customer, there's different steps into that process. First, it's contribution of the content. Second is bringing and processing the content into the studio. Third is preparing the content for distribution. And fourth is really pushing the content into the access network, which can be an HFC network, a DTH network, a CDN network, whatever that is today. Today, all these networks are operated in silos. That means that there's limited flexibility to add new services to the lineup. And that's what you see today. If people like satellite operators, broadcasters, and you name it, want to add new services, typically that's a process that can take a couple of weeks or even months. What we show here is that we can set up these new services in just a couple of minutes rather than days or weeks or months. And how does that work? Very simple. The first concept is that we set up workflows across the board. So whether it's, if it's a live event, so to speak, we can push the live event, set up all the connections for the live event towards the studio, route it in the studio, process it, push it into the distribution headend, whether it's a linear TV headend for the first screen, whether it's a cloud infrastructure for the second and the third screen, and push it into the distribution network. That's one important facet of what we call unified workflows. Now, to make that work, there's a couple of things that are required, of course. First is the selection of the technology. Many customers have many different types of contribution feeds. Some use satellites, some use fiber, some use a hybrid system, some use SDH type of equipment, some use MPLS. Now, giving the flexibility to choose whatever network is available at a good cost at that time gives the flexibility to launch those new services very fast. So what we provide is the capability to set up contribution sessions on whatever technology that is available. The other thing is, and we do that for all the parts in the distribution chain. For instance, for the distribution headend, if you look around here on the show, there's a lot of talk about virtualization, cloud processing, cloud media processing. We handle that today. On the show, there's some other demos on other booths even that show that. So we manage traditional compression equipment. We also manage cloud infrastructure to process that media. So that's a second important thing about unified workflows. Not only crossing multiple parts of the silos, so to speak, but also within those silos supporting multiple technologies. Now, at the basis of all of that is to be able to control and manage all the different brands of equipment. Because if you look at the whole chain here, probably the whole set of vendors here on the whole are involved in one or another way to process that media. We are uniquely placed to be able to work with all these different vendors, and there's more than 5,000 different device types that we support today to make all of that happen. So that's, to me, is providing a total solution to the customers, being able to process media through the whole chain, through whatever technology, to whatever technology brand that is used to process the transmission or the compression. Well, the value is basically in the fact that the infrastructure and the staffing can be used very efficiently. Yeah? So all of a sudden, if you have access to any part of the network to process a service, to deliver or transmit a service, you can do that very effectively. because you can just pick and choose whatever network part is available at that time. So that saves you a lot of CapEx investment, so to speak. So using resources efficiently is a key benefit of that. Same goes for the operational aspect of it. Today, many networks are still operated in silos. There's an operations team for the contribution satellite part, there's a contribution team to manage the MPLS network, there's typical teams to do the linear TV, there's other teams going to be set up for the cloud infrastructure. Having one and the same management system basically means that you can have one set of operators managing the whole thing. So there goes your cost savings in terms of operational staff. And the other thing is, of course, the bandwidth savings. If you can pick and choose the right technology at the right moment in time, you can use our satellite space segment, which is still very expensive, optimally. You can use your MPLS network very efficiently at the right time. You can choose between using live transmissions or file transmissions overnight, as an example. So that gives you a lot of benefit. So efficiency is a clear benefit. But what I hear on the show, talking to many customers already, is the clear benefit to have the flexibility and the elasticity to launch new services very fast. Because whatever part of the infrastructure you need at a certain moment in time, you can immediately access to launch that new service. A third aspect to the value that we bring on the table is also related to bringing out new services very fast, and is also related to cost savings. Having one and the same multi-vendor network management system allows you to integrate all the services into an upper layer operational and business system very easily, because it's only one integration that has to be done. So there you go, there you gain a lot of time, there you gain a lot of money. The challenges to us, if I can talk about us and FSC in the market, there's many challenges. First of all, and it all starts with understanding the customer, it starts with understanding the market and where we're going. But that would be the answer of everybody here in the room, right? The clear challenge that we have seen many years ago, and we have worked on that, of course, is to be able to manage all the different brands of equipment. Because that's the starting point. If you cannot access the resources in the network, if you cannot monitor them, if you cannot control them, then all of this doesn't work. That all falls apart. So from a technology perspective, being able to talk to thousands of devices, different types of devices, is kind of the starting point. The second thing would be on the product side. On the product side, it's important to have a large set of vertical integrated functions, ranging from element management, network management, service management, SLA management, and all the operational support processes, which increasingly become important, to have all of that integrated into the package. That's important. The other thing is, as networks grow, the amount of content ever grows, the amount of sources grows, the amount of delivery profiles grows, complexity grows, so you need a product that is very scalable in terms of amount of resources, in terms of handling amount of services. So I think what makes the difference is being able to have a good technology, a good product, and of course, a good understanding of the market and the customers. Providing total solutions basically means that you have to have access to everything, as I just mentioned. And what that means is that a service provider, an operator, a satellite operator, a cable operator, you name it, has to be able to rely on a company and a solution that is independent and not influenced by any specific technology brand. So there's many companies here at the show. Everybody has its good products, everybody is excelling in some area. Operators need to be able to pick and place the best technology wherever they want to. They can only do that if they have a management system in place that can just work with everybody without being influenced in one or another way by a system integrator or by a specific technology brand. So there, I think, working with a company that is only focusing on solving these things being independent of any other technology providers or system integration houses, is that would be my clear recommendation there.